Okay, well, we're gonna finally finish the handle of machete. It seems like it's been taking forever because got a little busy with my paying job. And you can ignore the crap music in the background and Jordan singing if you can hear him.
Hey, if you'd show up on time, you wouldn't have to do this.
So anyway, we're gonna start working on the handle. We got some scrap lumber and some oak that we're gonna use. We've cut
that's
it in half.
Poplar.
Oh, wood. This one's poplar.
Yep.
Well, then you lied to me earlier this week. So I guess it's poplar.
Wood.
That's your fault. You lied to me. We're playing back and forth games. Basically, Jordan lies a lot and then blames me for everything. Same at work. So anyway,
it's all lies.
Anyway, we're gonna start sketching this out. I'm gonna put this on here. I'm gonna trace the shape I want. And then we'll come back and we'll start cutting this out.
And if you can't tell the difference between poplar and oak, you just need to go ahead and walk out the door.
Well, one of us actually works at work, and the other one just points fingers and walks around. Okay, so now I'm just going to trace out the shape I kind of want, mark where I want the distance to be on that side, and then I'm going to start cutting. Oh, that vibrated that right off. So yeah, I guess I need to clamp a little bit better.
The last time I edited a video for you, you weren't on camera most of the time.
On camera?
Just watching.
I bet you were doing something I couldn't see. Okay, now I'm going to round off this little bit right here. It's hard for you to see. Basically, I made a little curve for the end, so keep doing this. Clean it up on the sander. Okay, now that I roughed out one side, you can kind of see I got my contour where I want it started. I got it nice and flat on several sides. I'm gonna use it and I'm gonna lay it across my other one, my other side of my handle, and I'm going to trace it and rough it up, and then we'll lay it out on the handle again, and I'll see how I want to sand it, and we'll start working that direction. I laid out three holes along this. And, you know, Jordan is, showing off some other work that he's doing in the background. Basically, we're going to put some of these brass pins in it eventually. So what I'm going to do is I marked out three holes locations. I put a punch on them. I'm going to drill three out, and then I'll come back when we start to get ready to sand. Okay, so I drilled the holes, and I went ahead and drilled the holes in the wood because it's kind of a boring part, and you guys really don't need to see that. You can figure that out. So what I did, kind of a tip, is for the brass pins that we're going to put in this, went ahead and cut them a little long. I just put two of them. I'm going to put a third one in the center later. But what I'm going to do is so that way when I sand over at the sander, the handle's already lined up, and then I can take it on and off as I want. Because, I mean, these are on here, but they're not super tight. I can drive these pins out anytime I want. So just keep, start watching sanding. And I might actually make Jordan do some work here in a minute. Stay tuned. Hey, look, it's Jordan. He's actually going to work.
Yeah, eventually. So one of the first things I do when I'm sanding or grinding something complicated is I plan my moves. So I got a few things to address here, but one thing is I got to make sure I'm even on this back end. I get this curve, so I want to make sure that I've got enough elbow room. This bench grinder's in the way, and it's bolted down now because somebody likes things bolted down, Matt. So
that's so it doesn't slide all over the place. So that way, when you plan your moves, it doesn't move on you.
So I'm gonna have to make sure this elbow gets high enough. This inside, I'm gonna have to sand some metal, so I got to be conscious of that, thinking about it. And then Matt's kind of got me a little screwed up here. I got to trim this edge back so it matches this one. So I'll probably have to take the handle scales off. I can beat you. To get that done, so I'm just going to start sanding, and you guys are going to follow along as I spill my beer again.
That's the second one today. Beer's for drinking, not for spilling.
That's the last sip I get for a while because the sawdust really bothers me. And it's safety. So that looks pretty good. It's very comfortable. I like it. So before we go to hand sand, we're gonna switch this out. This is a 40 grit belt, so this is super coarse. I'm gonna go ahead and switch it out with a 120 I've got laying here. It's fairly warm. We'll hit it with 120. That's a 320. We'll start with 120. We'll start with that and we'll see how that takes us along. One thing I'm gonna do that I missed is I'm gonna add a chamfer right here. It'll just aesthetically make it look a little better. I'll take him off to do that, so I'll put those in real quick and then I'll switch belts. You don't have to do this pinned together, but once they're mate set, I like to keep them pinned together. So since Matt's over there, you know, drinking his, I'm gonna stand here and
I was thirsty.
Drink mine.
Somebody's getting a little ahead of themselves like normal.
Well, you know. I just finished mine a little closer. Alright, so we're getting ready to peen these over. Our epoxy setup for probably about 10 minutes roughly.
Where's your tool out there, Jordan?
It's over here.
Yeah, so who's getting ahead of themselves?
Hey, you're the one that decided mixed drinks at midnight, alright?
It's not midnight, it's midnight for old people like you. Vegans go to bed early, like when the sun goes down.
So we're cutting this off roughly an eighth inch, if I can get my hands to hold still.
I may have gave Jordan a little too much to drink today.
We're just going to throw that across the shop because I don't even care anymore. You probably can't see what I'm doing. Guess it don't matter, I'm just clipping these off. Okay, we got those clipped off. We're gonna take the ball peen. I'm gonna mushroom out one side, and I wanna make sure I get both sides mushroomed out before I go too crazy to get the look I wanna go for. So I try to use the corner of the anvil so I don't damage the wood too much as we're doing this. I'm also using the peen side of the hammer to make the head of this brass pin widen.
I don't know why I had to stop drinking so you could do this.
I'm thinking had I stopped drinking, it might be a little easier to do this.
You want me to do it for you? Yeah, it's a difficulty there, buddy.
I am. I'm all over the place here.
Now you just change adds character to the handle.
And we'll fix it later. This ain't the first time I've done this.
You sure?
Yep. And that's how that works. We got some things to fix up here, but we'll work on that here in a minute.
Okay, a little late finishing this, so we're gonna see. This is the machete.
So this is the machete. Handle's finished to 120 grit. Edge is good and sharp. It'll shave just fine. It'll cut. There's hair flying in the dark.
You can still see it on the camera, even surprisingly.
That'll do. Who we're making this for, we're going to let them finish the handle out. That's one heck of a machete.
Yeah, and we kind of left it, as you see, kind of the rustic. It's kind of hard to see in the dark. Actually, there you go. You kind of see we left a lot of the imperfections in it. We just kind of cleaned up the edge. It just kind of gives it that nice rustic look. Kind of a unique project. Jordan really wasn't a fan of this when it started. Now he kind of likes it, so
it turned out better than I expected.
So, you know, lawnmower blade, now into machete.
Stick around for the next one. Be sure to comment, like, and subscribe.
Good night.